Hello, 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 and welcome to Learn English Live 13. Yes, your questions keep pouring in, and I'm more than happy to clear up your doubts. So let's go to our first question from Sarah from Brazil.
Hi, Steve. My name is Sarah Basco. I'm from Brazil, and I love to study by your online English classes. But I have some doubts. And when I use the two or four, and when I use other and another. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and hello Sarah, and hello Brazil. Your question is something that mixes up a lot of English learners from beginners all the way to fluency level. So let's clear that up.
Two and four. Two and four. I'm gonna send an e-card for my grandma, 'cause grandma doesn't do email. I'm gonna send the e-card to her friend, 'cause grandma needs a favor. Two and four. Two and four. Important for me. Personally, important for me, everybody else. Important to me, personally, and me, just me. Two or four. Two or four. Do something to you, bad. Do something for you, good.
Now, a story that comes to mind is when I'm giving class to one of my advanced students who tries to give 150% of herself during our English lessons. The two versus four preposition thing comes up in our classes from time to time. And since there is no rule, sometimes she'll just lose it. Come on, Steve, this week it's two and the next week it's four. And of course, I'm like on the defensive here and saying, it's not my fault. I didn't make up the rules for the English language. So I'm going to give you some classic examples so that you can feel more confident. Send two versus send four. So let's say your grandmother doesn't know how to send an email. What? Yeah, it can happen. Some people don't do email for whichever reason.
Which button do I press to send email?
No, Grandma, that's for TVs.
Which channel is email on?
Leave it to me. I'll send the birthday e-card to your friend for you. So what did I just say? I said I would do my grandma a favor and send the e-card in her name. That is, I will send it for my grandma and I will send it to her friend. Now, do something to versus do something for someone. This is something that I've noticed come up in my classes a lot. Now, there's a huge difference here. If you say that my brothers did something to me, let's say they threw me into a pool of cold water, that means they did something bad to you. But if you said that my brothers did something for me, maybe they threw me a nice surprise birthday party or something. Important to versus important for. So the grammar book explanation is that, for example, being professional is important to me. To in this case means personally for me and me only. Being professional is important for me. For means either personally for me or for those around me. Now, question. Do you think, Steve, that most native speakers know the difference? No way. If only on an intuitive level, but I highly doubt it. Either one works well. I tend to use two. This kind of thing would only matter if you were writing a high-level grammar test. She asked to me or for me? She asked me. She gave to me my book? Uh-uh. She gave me my book. Or she gave my book to me. She told to me her secret? Uh-uh. She told me her secret. Or she told her secret to me. I will put together a preposition quiz so that you can practice your prepositions and the last grammar point that I was talking about. And I look forward to my next Learn English Live question and video explanation next time. Bye for now.
Preposition quiz. Click here to start.